Good morning. This is Kelloland on the go with all you need to know in news and weather as you start your day.
Authorities are urging people not to travel on roads today due to the blowing and drifting snow.
According to SD511, nearly every interstate and highway is either closed or has a no-travel advisory. For a look at the road conditions, let's send it out to Kelloland's Ariana Schumacher. Good morning, Ariana.
Good morning. Snow and blowing snow are falling in Sioux Falls here this morning, and road conditions are getting drifty. Check out these photos from Lincoln County Sheriff's Office. The blowing snow is causing significant drifting in some areas. Deputies say they've been having difficulty getting around all night. They urge people to stay home if you can. If you do have to be out on the roads today, make sure you're using caution and giving yourself extra time to get to your destinations. Giving yourself extra room between you and other vehicles, as well as not crowding the plows so they can do their jobs this morning. Reporting in Sioux Falls, Ariana Schumacher, Kelloland News.
Thank you, Ariana. The Sioux Falls School District has canceled classes for today due to the winter storm. School Activities and Kids Inc. have also been canceled. The Rapid City School District will have a two-hour late start to allow crews time to remove snow drifts. However, school officials say if parents feel the road conditions are too treacherous, they can keep their kids home. You can find all of the school closings on our clothesline page at kelloland.com. They are also scrolling at the bottom of your screen. Now let's send it over to meteorologist Adam Rutt for the latest on this winter storm. Good morning, Adam.
Good morning, Lauren, and good morning, everybody. We're finally starting to reach the end game with this system, but we're still not quite done with it yet. Between scattered snow showers, not to mention blowing snow for a better part of the day, we are unfortunately not quite done yet. Here's a view from our camera in Lake Preston to kick things off. A lot of snow, a lot of drifting snow as well. Road crews doing their best to try and keep up, but that wind is really going to wreak havoc. 18 degrees as we take a view downtown of the overpass, the 10th Street. West wind at 25 miles per hour. That does put the wind chill right around zero. Travel is going to be strongly discouraged due to the wind, the blowing snow, and those snow showers, which will continue to pinwheel on through. Temperatures this morning in the teens to near 20, but then you factor in that wind, which has been sustained at 25 to 35 miles per hour in many locations. That does put the wind chill near, if not below, zero across a large majority of the region. We're going to be talking about a lot more cold as we head into next week. We'll go over those details and the rest of your forecast coming up.
Thank you, Adam. Yesterday afternoon, the Pennington County Search and Rescue was notified of a missing person. One man had left earlier this week and was not heard from since. He became stuck near the Wyoming-South Dakota state line. He managed to stay warm in his car until he ran out of gas on Wednesday morning. Due to a poor signal, he was finally able to send a text before his phone died. Authorities then received the notification yesterday around 3 p.m. The man was found by Pennington County Search and Rescue around 8 o'clock last night. After an extraction by Snowcat, he was transferred for further medical attention at the hospital.
New this morning, we are hoping to learn more about an early morning incident in the northern part of Sioux Falls. Our Kelloland news crew was able to capture this video of the scene in the area of 54th and Cliff. Several police cars and firefighters were seen. We can also see significant damage to the side of a building, as well as a glimpse of a car inside the building. Stay with Kelloland News on air and online for updates as they become available.
The South Dakota Department of Transportation has rescued several stranded drivers in the last 36 hours, many of them in the central part of the state, which has seen a lot of blowing snow. While I-90 is closed, some drivers are trying to get through on secondary roads, but they're having a hard time maintaining and are impassable in places. The Highway Patrol says it's a dangerous situation.
The roads are going to deteriorate very quickly. You may be able to see right now, but you go down the road another 200 feet and the visibility drops to zero.
The Department of Public Safety issued a travel warning yesterday afternoon saying no travel was advised across much of South Dakota because many of the roads are blocked.
People in Sioux Falls didn't waste much time cleaning up the snow that started yesterday morning. Belle Karst says her father taught her to start shoveling right away, so now it's a habit.
Just trying to get ahead of it before even more comes down.
Another shoveler we talked to wanted to get started on it now before the temperatures take a dive next week. And that's a look at some of our top stories.
Now let's get one last look at your weather with meteorologist Adam Rutt. Adam?
We are going to continue to keep an eye on blizzard conditions over the course of your day. Blizzard warnings in white until 3 p.m. Central, 2 p.m. Mountain Time for about 75% of South Dakota, if not maybe even a little bit more of that. Winter storm warnings in red from Mitchell to Brookings, including Madison. That's until 3 p.m. Central Time today. Winter weather advisories in blue, Yankton to Sioux Falls into Marshall, Spencer, Worthington, and Pipestone. That's also until 3 p.m. today. The winter weather advisory for central portions of the Black Hills, that's until noon central, 11 mountain time. A winter storm warning up for the northern hills, also until noon central, 11 mountain time. The winter weather advisory to the southwestern corner of the state until 2 p.m. mountain time. Yes, a lot to unpack, but the take-home message is pretty simple. Still dealing with snow showers, still dealing with blizzard conditions, and a lot of wind as well, with low pressure very slow to get on out of here. It does gradually depart, though, but that's the key word, gradually. So snow showers will continue to pinwheel through over the course of the afternoon. The wind will continue to whip up all of that snow, creating very hazardous travel conditions over the course of the day and into the night. By the weekend, we do calm down. The wind does back off a little bit, but then that gets replaced with a lot of cold. High temperatures today in the upper teens to low 20s in many locations, with lows tonight in the single digits above zero. But again, it is going to be windy, and we will still deal with windswept snow across a large majority of the region. Here's your 7-day forecast. It gets very cold by the middle of next week, regardless of which 7-day forecast you take a look at. We're also going to look at the chance for some midweek snow next week by Wednesday across the region. But before we get to that, we have to deal with the blowing snow and scattered snow showers in Aberdeen and in Pier as well before we get ready for that bitter cold for the middle of next week. Even Rapid City doesn't escape it as well, with temperatures falling into the single digits above zero by the middle of next week. Stay safe. Have a great day, everybody. For more on your local news and weather, you can always head on over to KelloLand.com.